insect body wall, its structure and function, and the process of molting in insects. The body wall, which is also called as integument or exoskeleton, is nothing but it is the external covering of the body, appendages, alimentary canal, tracheal system, and the ducts, and those organs which are covered by this exoskeleton are ectodermal in origin, and then this exoskeleton is rigid, flexible, lighter, stronger, and it is variously modified in different parts to suit the different modes of life. And the structure of the body wall, it have three parts. The first one is basal non-cellular layer, which is also called basement membrane, and the second one is the inner cellular layer, which is also called epidermis, and then the third one is outer non-cellular part, which is the cuticle. Then the basement membrane is an amorphous granular layer, and it is secreted by the blood cells, and it is 0.5 micron thickness, and it contains the mucopolysaccharides. This is the section of insect cuticle. Here you can see the basement membrane at the base, and then the endocuticle, exocuticle, and the epicuticle. Here you can see that the endocuticle is larger in size than the exocuticle, and then epicuticle, and the hair-like structure is called trichoid sensillum. And here you can see the dermal glands, and then the trichogen. The setae forming cells is called the trichogen, and one another terminology is there called tarmogen. The socket forming cells is called as tarmogen. Please note that the socket forming cells is called tarmogen. This is the another picture of the insect integument, the trichogen cell, the epidermal cells, then the dermal glands, which are able to secrete the wax, then endocuticle, exocuticle, and this bristle is called as the setae. The cuticle have three sublayers. The first one is the endocuticle, second one exocuticle, third one is the epicuticle. The endocuticle is the innermost and thickest layer, and it is made up of chitin and the arthropodin, and it is colorless, soft, and flexible. Due to the presence of arthropodin, this endocuticle is very soft and flexible. And then exocuticle, it is the middle layer. It is much thicker with the composition of the chitin and sclerotin. The sclerotin protein is very hard, so the exocuticle is dark in color, and it is more rigid. The endocuticle and exocuticle together called as the procuticle, and then the epicuticle, it is the outermost layer, and it is very thin. And the epicuticle is differentiated into four layers. First one is inner epicuticle, which contains the wax filaments, and second one is the cuticulin, it is the non-chitinous polymerized lipoprotein layer, and then the wax layer. They contain the closely packed wax molecules, which prevents the desiccation. We already seen that the wax layer prevents the water loss from the insects. And then the cement layer, it is the outermost layer. It is formed by the lipid and tanned proteins. It protects the wax layer. It is much more harder than the wax layer, and it prevents the wax layer from abrasion. In the composition of the insect cuticle, the first one is the chitin, then arthropodin, sclerotin, and resilin. In general, our cuticle is composed of two components. The one is chitin and another one is protein. That protein either be arthropodin or sclerotin. And then first of all, the chitin, it is the main constituent of cuticle, and it is a nitrogenous polysaccharide and a polymer of N-acetyl glucosamine with beta-1,4 glycosidic linkages. It is insoluble in water, but it is soluble in dilute acids, alkalis and some other organic solvents. If the chitin is boiled with concentrated KOH at 160 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes, it will give the chitosan, which on treatment with 0.2% iodine, it gives rose violet color. And then arthropodin, it is an untanned protein and it is water soluble. And you can see this in the endocuticle of the insect. And then this sclerotin, it is the tanned protein and it is water insoluble, and this protein is present in the exocuticle of the insect. And then resilin, it is just a elastic protein which is responsible for the flexibility of wing sclerites, and it is present in the area of the wing sclerites. Then endoskeleton. The endoskeleton is cuticular in growth of body wall, and they provide the space for muscle attachments. And there are two types. First one is apodem and second one is apophysis. Apodem is the hollow invagination of the body wall. Otherwise, it is a ridge-like hollow invagination of body wall. And the apophysis, it is the spine-like solid invagination of the body wall. You can remember here, there is 2S in apophysis. Here you can see spine-like solid invagination. You can get clue from here. Then the cuticular appendages. There are two types of cuticular appendages. First one is non-cellular and then cellular. Under the non-cellular appendages, the minute hairs and thorns will come. They have no epidermal association and they are rigidly attached to the cuticle itself. And then cellular appendages have the epidermal association, since the epidermal layer is cellular in origin and it is living. And further, the cellular appendages are divided into unicellular and multicellular. Under the unicellular appendages, the examples are clothing hairs or plumose hairs present in the honeybee, and then bristles present in the flies like housefly, and the flattened outgrowth of the body wall present in the moths and butterflies is called scales. And then the caterpillar have the glandular setae, and these setae will secrete the poison. And you can able to hear, and you already hear the story that the hairy caterpillars, if touched, means they will cause irritations. These chemicals are secreted by this glandular setae only. Then the sensory setae, they are associated with the sensory neuron. And then generally the setae means it is hair like outgrowth of the epidermis. Then the multicellular appendages. The movable multicellular appendage is called spur, and immovable cellular appendage is called spine. You can see it is the setae, the hair like structure. It is unicellular in origin, and I already explained that the epidermal cells generating the setae is called trichogen, and the socket forming cells is called ptarmogen. And the study of arrangement of setae is known as ketotaxy. It is important question, please note that the study of arrangement of setae is known as ketotaxy. And this is the microtrachea. They are non-cellular in origin,